Welcome back to Fallout 4. Since the last episode, I have done tons of stuff. I haven't done any quests or any exploring, of course. I'm saving that for when I actually record. But I did a massive amount of settlement building and also just general modifications to the game. In fact, you're already staring at a lot of the modifications that I've made to the settlement. And yeah, there's just tons of stuff to show you. I'm just gonna start going down the list and showing you all the cool things that I've done or seen or made. And hopefully I don't leave anything out. So, let's start with one thing. I put welding goggles on dog meat. I was searching online for stuff that dog meat can wear, and as it turns out, welding goggles is one of them. And it's so adorable! I was thinking the goggles might be, like, on top of the head, but I wasn't expecting them to actually be over the eyes. But they are actually over the eyes. And it's adorable, my little red bandanaed and goggled adventure doggy. It is amazing looking. It looks so cute! Oh, dog meat. Okay, some other stuff I've done. As you can see, I've made this little doghouse here. I stuffed it full of teddy bears. Because I figured dog meat would like to play with bears. You know, maybe tear them apart a bit, if he feels like it. Or maybe just cuddle with them. Also built a little light here, and a dog bowl, of course. Gotta drink, gotta eat. I also have a shrine to dogs here. It is nothing but a picture of a dog, and a light, and a disco ball thing, and also some of dogs' favorite stuff. It is a shrine to dogs, and it is beautiful. Also, probably the thing I'm most excited to show you, in fact I probably should have started with this, but oh well. I got the idea. Undertale, the game Undertale, has a lot of really cute dogs, and I remember them sounding really cute too. So I got the idea, what if I took the dog sounds from Undertale and replaced Dog Meat's sounds with the Undertale dog sounds? And so that is exactly what I've done to Dog Meat's barks. Dog Meat's barks are now copied from Undertale. It is, oh my god, just check this out.
Hey. Over here. Move here. Here. Head over there. Go there. There. Move out. Over there.
Dog meat just sounds like a little squeak toy. Oh, those dog sounds from Undertale are so cute. There's only two of them. There's only two bark sounds from Undertale, unfortunately. I wish there was a greater variety, but it's okay. The two are enough.
Hey, get into position. Wait there. Come on. Hold position.
It's so cute. I love it. So yeah, I'm pretty sure every bark, or almost every bark that dog meat can make is replaced with those sounds. Oh, I love it so much. Okay, what else is there to show you? Oh, I installed a mod. There's this full dialogue replacement mod or something like that, which means when you talk to people... when you talk to people, instead of getting the dialogue wheel thing, you get this list, which has a couple benefits. One, each item actually will actually display the full line of text that you're going to say.
How you doing, buddy?
Like this? Oh, come back here. So it actually displays exactly what your character is going to say. Not like an abbreviated version, but the full thing you're going to say. That's one of the benefits. And the other benefit is you can actually use the number keys to select the dialogue entries that you want to go with. So you don't have to click on them anymore, you can actually just press the number keys. So it's an itemized list, or whatever you want to call it. It's a lot more convenient. It's much clearer what you're going to say, and it's easier to control.
Never mind, boy.
So that's gonna be cool. Alright, what's some other stuff to show you?
Hey.
Why don't you go hang out in your doghouse?
Go check that out.
Go in there, boy. Go in there. Go be with your teddy bears. Alright, some other stuff I've done. I have spruced up this place a bit. I put some pictures around. There's another dog. And there's a kitten. There's another dog. There's a couple more kittens. There's another kitten. It feels a lot more homely, you know? But there's even more. I've also planted a bunch of stuff back here. There's not a lot of people to actually farm all these plants, but if I do get more people, there's plenty of crops for them to farm. Also, I've made a crazy tower into the sky. I've got to admit, it doesn't look very pretty. But damn, is it a pretty cool view. Check it out. This is about as far as I can build up. And it is beautiful. It's got a pool table with no balls and no pool cues or anything like that. So it's, it could use some work. But still, you know, the thought is there. You could just imagine the balls, imagine the pool cues, imagine you're playing with somebody else. It's almost like the real thing. I've also set up a shrine to Sean. You remember Sean? I wouldn't blame you if you didn't remember Sean. But Sean was my son, you know, that I'm supposed to be searching for. You know, the main quest of the game that I've kind of been ignoring for like 10 hours. You know, my son that's missing, been stolen from me, supposed to be searching for him. You know, that's Sean. So this is actually Sean's crib. It's literally Sean's crib, it's not just a generic crib, it is actually Sean's crib. As you can see. As it says on the top right, Sean's crib. And just to remind me of Sean, I put Jangles the Moon Monkey. I just imagined that's Sean. It's close enough, about the right size. Maybe a little bit too big, and I don't think Sean was an astronaut. So, it's not an exact match, but it's pretty close. And you know what I like to do? I like to listen to the soothing music of these speakers. And I like to sit in this airplane seat and contemplate existence. Ah, Sean. I'm coming for you. In like 50 hours, once I've collected everything that isn't nailed down. Now, let's turn this off before my ears start bleeding. Okay, I think that's pretty much everything. I added a couple more lights. Oh, I built a trash can back here. Yeah, big news, trash can, woohoo! I also added a light here. So it looks a little bit more lit up. Added some more water, I think. I think that's about it. I also made some minor improvements to the settlements all around this entire place, just kind of added more beds, radio beacons, and stuff like that to try to increase the happiness of my other settlements around the wasteland, and yeah, I think that actually is it. It was a lot of work. You ready to get adventuring? Let's start adventuring again. What shall we do? I still need to turn in a quest, don't I? Which one was it? This one. Okay, where are you? Alright, she's not too far from Oberlin Station. So let's go over to Oberlin Station. This is the one where I need to turn in to the person who is unfortunately the supply line person who goes between settlements. So I need to kind of find her on the road because she's rarely actually here. Now that I've teleported here, how far away is she? Okay, well, she's most of the way to the castle. I suppose by the time I get to the castle, she's probably going to be there. Gotta try to hunt her down. She's on the road. Oh yeah! Looks like I got it just right. She's almost here. Perfect. Hey, aren't you supposed to bring a Brahmin with you? Poor thing just came out of the water. You know, didn't they say the castle was rumored to have been destroyed by a sea monster? Perhaps it was a heavily laden Brahmin coming out of the sea. Alright.
Took care of those ghouls that were giving you trouble.
You did? That's great news.
That's it? I was expecting more. Bah. Alright, time to talk to Preston. See if he has any more quests for me. He always has quests for me. Our settlements are increasing in size. Sanctuary's up to 11 people.
Heads up. Stay there. Moving out. Stay there, boy. On me. Stay. Let's go.
I just wanted to hear dog meat bark. Preston.
Shit. Whoa.
Oh my god, this is the first time we're actually getting assaulted. Fuck you, psycho. And taking out my settlers. Oh my god, the Brahmin's on fire. You poor thing. Are you dead? No, just tired, I guess. Get him, dog meat. So cute. Any more? I hear gunfire. I think it's on the other side of Sanctuary. We might be getting attacked from two places. Let's grab the useful stuff and let's go. Poor Brahmin was on fire. And yeah, can you... Oh, I can't give him a stim pack, so... Can't help him, but he's still breathing, so I guess he's alive. I'm assuming your settlers can actually die, and then you actually lose members of your settlement. Oh, is it Codsworth fighting this Raider Psycho? Sure you were, Codsworth. Okay, I think we're good now. Yeah, let's check the settlement numbers. Still 11 people here, so nobody died. Good. That makes me think we need more defenses. Let me see if I have the stuff to build more defenses. Wouldn't mind a couple more turrets. Yeah, I can build two more machine gun turrets. Alright, so they came from this way. Put one there. And let's also put one over here. Because I've got a lot of my defenses focused on the bridge. I just assume that's where they'd be coming from. But it looks like that might have been a wrong assumption, because a bunch of them came from over here. Alright, cool. Preston! You already went to sleep. Jesus Christ, look, there's blood and bodies all over the place.
Hi.
Wakey wakey.
Apparently the castle's been trying to get you on the radio. Some kind of situation over there. Better go see what's going on.
It just came from there. Alright, I'll go back. Ooh, there's three people at the castle now. Before there was only one. Alright, what do you need?
Can we trade a few things?
No, I don't want to trade.
I hope you're finding the broadcast useful.
Seems to be in working order.
Am I supposed to talk to somebody? Why is that highlighted? Ronnie Shaw, who are you?
Ah, there you are, finally. I've been waiting to talk to you.
Who are you?
I'm Ronnie Shaw, Commonwealth Minutemen. At least I was. Back before Joe Becker got himself killed and the idiots took over.
Idiots. I don't think I've ever seen anybody pronounce idiot. Idiot.
Joe Becker? Who's that?
That's just sad. General Becker used to run the Minutemen. The last real leader we ever had. After he died, there wasn't anybody left with the guts and brains to pull things together.
What do you actually want?
I didn't mean to be that snippy.
Heard you were trying to get the Minutemen back on their feet. Thought I'd come see the new general for myself. So what's your story? What makes you think anybody even wants the Minutemen back?
Well, how about the fact that we've already been helping lots of people that have asked for help?
The Commonwealth needs the Minutemen. People are starting to realize that.
I've heard some good things. Wouldn't be here otherwise. Now that I'm here, I can see you really need my help.
Are you offering to rejoin?
I guess I am, but first things first. I'm probably the only one who still remembers this, but the castle's armory was located in the West Bastion. All of our best equipment was stored there. Weapons, ammo, schematics, you name it. Come on, I'll show you.
Please do. Can always use good equipment.
Good afternoon.
How the heck do you open this thing?
Broadcasting across the Commonwealth.
Good. Looks like it might still be intact. Door's still sealed. Bastion hasn't collapsed. Trick now is finding a way in.
Do you know some way to open this door?
No. And even if we could blast it open, we'd probably destroy what's inside while we're at it. If you can't go through, go around. Let's have a look at the Northeast Bastion.
Take your time, Ronnie. Not like I have people to save or anything. Let's play dog meat.
Heads up.
Right here, boy. Go. Right here, pal. Over here, boy. Over there, boy.
Check it out.
This was the general's quarters.
Used Go,
to be a
boy.
Tunnel leading from here to the armory. This tunnel's blocked by this rubble. We'll have to find some way to clear it.
Is that a suggestion that I should use the missile launcher? She just sits down? What, like, that's supposed to help me? Need to find some way to get through this rubble. Oh, I'm tired. I'm gonna sit down. I'm going on lunch break.
Come on, General. You must have some way to clear this rubble.
Yeah, give me a second. Oh, wait. I'm supposed to go over there. What's over here? Am I supposed to make something? Oh wait, am I supposed to just like delete the rubble? Oh my god. You literally just delete the rubble.
Let's get down there and see if there's still a way through.
How dramatic. I received expert training to enter build mode and delete rubble.
Pretty dark down here. We better watch our step.
Well, I don't think we're gonna find people down here. But there could be ghouls or mire lurks, maybe. Oh, crap, radiation. There's like a strange mist in the air around here. I wonder what it is. Cannonballs! That's old school. Alright, I've got 100 pounds of cement. Come
Look
here,
alive.
Dog
meat. Over there!
You should hold my cement, boy. Come on.
Go on, boy.
Whoa, what the fuck?
I think that's it.
Ronnie, you think it might have been a bad idea to shoot a laser weapon in a room full of explosive gas just to kill a little, like, rad roach? Come on.
Hi, Ronnie.
I'll back you up, Jen.
Whoops. Don't talk to me.
My night vision ain't what it used to be.
Look alive.
Yeah, each bag of cement weighs 8. Let's get rid of my missile launcher too. Super heavy. There we go. Well, at least the explosion got rid of the radiation in this room. Hello. Oh, crap.
Hold.
Oh, that was about to blow up there. I mashed my way to victory, just barely. Oh, God. Laser musket. Ooh! Laser muskets can be charged by pressing R repeatedly. The more charges, the higher the damage. Oh my god. I need to check that out. That could be really, really good. Sounds like if you want to shoot fast, it's not a good thing, but, you know, if you got plenty of time and you're just trying to charge a headshot from afar in vats or something like that, then that sounds really, really nice. What the heck is that? It's a floating bolt. Yeah, somebody wanted to make sure that anybody who came down here who did not belong would die. Trapped the place and then left it. Yeah, trying to kill us. I thought you said don't worry. So much for that. Hold on. Nope. Just trying to blow up the arms. Fuck. Blow off its arm? No, I didn't. Let's see how this thing fares. How's my health doing? Where's my health? Oh, there it is. For some reason, my health isn't being displayed. There we go, now it's being displayed. It's helpful to know your health, game! Especially when you're fighting a boss. Okay, I got the arm.
Be advised, hostiles in area. Threat neutralization.
Forever, as far as I know.
That was a cool fight.
United we stand. Yeah, that was it.
Good job. Where the hell's Dogmeat? Oh no, did I tell Dogmeat to stand somewhere and then he just stay there and isn't moving? Dogmeat!
Hey, over here.
Come here. Oh, I love those barks so much. What do I have that's so heavy? I guess it's a laser musket. 15 pounds? Yeah, I think it is. I'm gonna check out the laser musket once I'm out of this place.
Guess the uniform is yours now, if you want it. So Geezer doesn't need it anymore. Rest in peace, General. Your fight is done, and the Minutemen live on.
General McGann.
There's no point in getting all sentimental about something that happened 40 years ago. Come on, we're almost through.
Door control unlocked. All right, that's fine. User logs. Attacked in the night. Last night at about 0200, I was woken by a crash that shook the whole castle. Lieutenant Foster reported that some huge creature had breached the western wall. Oh, that must be the sea creature that was rumored to have messed up the place, right? Ruined it? I sent him to radio for reinforcements, while I used the tunnels to lock down the armory. Shortly after that, a second crash caved in the only other exit from the tunnel. The only thing I can think of large enough to do that kind of damage is a behemoth. And if super mutants have taken the courtyard, I can't risk the artillery falling into their hands. All I can do for now is set up defenses and wait for someone to dig me out. Bolstered my position. It's now clear that we must have lost the battle. I've heard something pounding on the armory door, but the walls will fall in before that door gives way. In case they attempt to clear the rubble from my quarters, I've set up all the defenses that were left down here. I don't like to think about super mutants using our artillery against helpless settlements. I'm running low on water, but I still hope that the survivors will regroup and mount a counterattack in time. Low on water, but not wine, apparently. Final entry. This will likely be my final entry. My supplies have all run out, and I've given up hope that rescue is coming. The only thing left is an old case of wine I found. I know it will only make the dehydration worse, but at this point I'd rather meet my fate with a toast. That you did, General. What the hell? There's a skeleton in the wall. That's creepy. Let's take a look at the uniform. Whoa, look at the energy weapon resistance, 80. It's really nice. But it looks like it replaces everything. Like, it seems to remove all the armor. Eh, I'm not gonna put it on. It'd be too annoying to put everything else back on. Ah, here we go. Other side of the door. What'd you find, dog meat? What'd you find? What'd you find, boy?
Now, let's see what kinds of
good boy,
are
good boy. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, look at how excited he is. He loves the goodies. My adventure doggy.
Excellent. The armory's still intact. Everything we need just waiting for us. And the cream of the crop, schematics for building artillery.
7 p.m. here at Radio Freedom. Nothing to report.
I have to admit, Ronnie, having artillery would help out quite a bit.
Oh, we used to rain down fire on Deathclaws and super mutants alike. It was a glorious thing. All right, grab that schematic and let's get going. Don't forget to grab some smoke grenades, too.
Does this mean I'm actually going to be able to build artillery? Is this going to add to my ability to build stuff? I hope so. Oh, so many crafting ingredients. Laser musket, medium scope, beam splitter. It's got mods for the laser musket. Okay, I was going to wait until I'm out of this place to check out the laser musket, but I think it's time to do it right here, right now, once I've collected all this stuff. Baseball grenade! That is so cool looking! Grenades, mines, stealth boys, oh those are worth a lot. Carrying too much, don't care, purified water. Laser musket, 4-crank capacitor, fusion cells, so many goodies. A fat man. Anything hiding on the top shelf? Nope. I think that's it. Oh, no, forgot a shelf. Laser musket, scattered laser musket, another laser musket, take them all. Beautiful. Alright, I'm extremely heavy. Oh, Dogmeat can't carry anymore. No! Well, for now, let's just take a look at the laser musket. Alright, got three of them. Let's see, fire rate is low. Fire rate's pretty low, so right now it's more of a sniper, like proper sniper rifle, not a quick fire sniper rifle. So let's compare it to the two-shot. So compared to the two-shot, damage is way less, fire rate is much higher, range is higher, accuracy is lower, weight is pretty good, value's low. Let's install those mods and see how much we can tweak it. What about scattered laser musket? Is that like the same thing, but just with a tweak? Short stock, standard capacitor. I think it's the same thing except it has a... This has an extended long barrel and this has a short barrel. That seems to be the only difference. So let's go with the full-on laser musket. Oh, I need science. That's right. This is an energy weapon. Crap. 4-crank reload maximum. So if you can crank it more, I assume that means you can just do more damage. Simple as that. Probably. Oh, but I just attached it even though I don't have science, because I already had it. I didn't need to build it. You only need science to build it, not to install it, I guess. Huh. Okay, cool. Take a look at the barrels. So that's science one, but it's already on there. Okay, good. Stock, full stock, good. Standard sights. I guess long scope, probably. Do I want to use this thing from a really far range? I think I do. So let's go with the long scope. Now let's see how this thing actually performs. Ooh, it's beautiful. Oh, so each crank actually takes up one ammunition. Oh, look at it glow. Yeah, so each crank takes up one ammunition, so I'm guessing the damage is per shot. So the damage is like 50 or something right now, so I'm guessing four cranks is the base damage times four. That means this would be like the best. Yeah, look at that. It even... you can do it really fast, too. I'm guessing this would be, like, the best sniper crit damage weapon. In terms of getting the most damage for a single shot you can get, this would be the best. Obviously, it'd be terrible in a firefight if you're close to anybody. But if you're from a long distance and you're just trying to get headshots and crits and stuff like that, then this would be really good, I think. Yeah. Can't wait until I have science and I can start making some of the science mods for this, but already it's pretty damn good. I'm gonna keep it on me. And I'm gonna crawl my way over to the workbench and dump some of my extra stuff. I'll be right back. Okay, everything's sorted away. I also went ahead and moved the weapon workbench from inside of the place to outside right next to the workshop, so much easier to access. I also put my cryolator on Dogmeat, in Dogmeat's inventory instead of on myself, because it's very heavy and I haven't had ammo for it for quite a while. And in its place I put this thing. So I'll save a bit on weight. Okay, so what about this artillery, Ronnie?
Hi.
Looks like you've got everything we need. As soon as you get some artillery built, we'll do a test fire to calibrate it.
Okay, what do we need? So I actually get to build it. Oh, cool. Oh, I've already got everything it needs. Yeah. Produces 6 defense. Dang, I can actually make like 5 of these things. I wouldn't have the people to man them, but I can make them. Use artillery smoke grenades to call in artillery strikes on your enemies. Oh, that is so cool. I don't know how much damage that actually does, but I'm assuming it's a lot. Dog meat! Rolling around on the ground, you cutie. Alright, now we need to assign somebody to it. Who would like to be the artillery person? How about you?
Got it.
Hi.
Ah, gosh darn, it's good to see artillery here again. So here's the thing about the big guns. They can't fire at anything too close, but their range is impressive. That's what the smoke grenades are for. Toss one of those at the bad guys. If we have artillery in range, we'll confirm over the radio and target our fire on your smoke. But first, we better do a test fire. Make sure we're hitting what we're aiming at. You see that little building over there? We'll use that for our aiming point. Keep your radio on and tuned to Radio Freedom so we can confirm we're ready.
I hope that music doesn't get my channel banned. So just...
All right, General, if you can hear me, we're ready. Toss one of those smoke grenades into the target area and we'll start the test fire.
Copy. Close enough. I'm gonna back up. Can that artillery really shoot that close? That's actually really, really close.
Okay. We've got your smoke on the target.
Hey,
dog meat, get back.
Head over there.
I wanna stand back.
Yeah, get back,
and,
dog meat.
You know,
go there.
Case.
Stay, boy.
Looks like they're cranking it. Yep. Oh. So there's more than one shot. These explosions are so pretty. Oh, there's more.
That looked good from here. You've now got artillery support. Use it wisely, General.
Well, that is very slow. It's very slow, so, you know, if I'm in the middle of a firefight, I don't think I can really use that too much. I maybe could, if I, like, threw it and then, like, hid or something. Possibly. But if I'm like a sniper and I'm scouting out a location and I see a bunch of really strong enemies, then I could toss it in there before they've even seen me. If they start getting pelted with artillery fire and they haven't actually spotted me, will that make them spot me? Or would they just run around like crazy because they don't know, you know, they don't see me and they're just getting blown up, so maybe they wouldn't know what to do? I'm trying to think of when I'd use these. I don't know, but I'm sure I'll find a use for him.
Follow me.
Come on, you little squeaky toy. Alright, what to do now? Oh, gotta go back to Preston. Actually, I've got two quests that have me talk to Preston. I feel like the more quests I complete, the more quests I have. Oh, I'm still tuned into the radio.
Mom, well,
seems to be growing well. Excuse me.
I've got to hand it to you, General. You've really turned things around for the Minutemen. I never thought I'd see the day that the Minutemen had artillery support again. We should see about building them at all our settlements to expand our coverage. And Ronnie Shaw returns. She's something else, isn't she?
She's the only one left who remembers when the castle was Minutemen HQ. She knew about the old armory.
I'd heard stories about her from the old-timers, but I didn't know she was still around. The fact that she's come back to the Minutemen means we must be doing something right. I'll let you know if I hear of any settlements that need our help. In the meantime, make sure to offer help to anyone that needs it. That can only help our cause.
Don't think we're quite done, Preston.
I cleared out the ghouls that were giving that settlement trouble.
Glad to hear it, General. It's hard enough out here without people having to worry about ghouls in their backyard.
Leveled up, nice. Oh, looks like it's harvesting time too.
Hmm.
My back hurts, my feet hurt. Everything hurts.
Yeah, good enough.
Hey.
Oh, also, I planted some razor grain, over here. And it's like the only razor grain I have. Yeah. It's the only razor grain I have, so I want to make sure I keep planting it so it can multiply. Because I have so little of it. So let's plant some more right now. Huh, that's weird. You can plant two different varieties of razor grain. They produce exactly the same amount of food, except one is, like, half the size. And we can build more artillery, so let's do that. Where should I put you? How about right there? Now, somebody needs to man that. Let's get everybody to come here. Hopefully I've got some extra people.
Need something?
I do. What is your job? Looks like she does plants over that way. Wait a minute, you're already assigned to the... How is Mama Murphy already assigned to their artillery? I mean, she does have the sight. Maybe she knew I was going to assign her to it anyway? Is it actually assigned? It is assigned. Huh. Alright, cool. Sorry, false alarm. Go back to your... whatever you're doing.
At least it's not raining.
What do you mean?
Tied to the...
You know what I feel like? I feel like going on some adventure. I've been doing lots of cool stuff this episode, but... I want to just go off and not do a quest. Not be stuck in the settlement builder. Let's just go someplace. Let's just go. Let's go shoot some things. Let's end the episode by going on a little adventure. Raiders come? Where? Oh, you're back. Now you're gone again. They're back on the roof, too? I feel like I got rid of all of them. I also need to spend my skill point. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna figure out what I want to spend my skill point on, and I'll be right back. Oh, well, that was an easy one to figure out. I just got to level 18, which means I've just reached the point where I can put another point into Rifleman. Attacks with non-automatic rifles now do 60% more damage and ignore 20% of a target's armor. Compared to my current one, which is 40% more damage and 15% of a target's armor. 20% more damage is really good. Just go to some place on the compass. Looks like that might be like a car park over there. That looks like that might be a police station. You coming, Dogmeat? Dogmeat will find his way. Always does. There you are! Good boy. Good teleporting dog. Detected. By what? Oh! What we got here? Raider scum, raider... Waster, alright.
Don't you die on me! How much you got left in you?
Who's this shirtless guy? Hanging out over there. He's got like a navy hat on. Those enemies? Scavenger. Are those enemies? Their names are red, so I think they are. Just want to make sure I don't kill somebody who isn't actually a bad person. I mean, I know that sounds really black and white. Kill bad people, don't kill good people. But let's be honest, this game is very black and white. I mean, this character is literally named Raider Scum. Oh. Huh, don't know what that was. It says detected, but it's green, so does that mean they're not going to attack me? Okay. Don't shoot dog meat, you asshole! See? That's what happens when you shoot dog- Oh, you- Fuck you. Don't kick my dog. Yeah, it is a Coast Guard hat. I thought so.
Hey. Move out. Move here.
You're dead.
Here. Heads up.
Okay, where was I trying to go in the first place? This MT something. MTA? They don't quite know where I am yet. Oh, don't worry, I am. Bad dog. Dog meat's a good dog, but you're a bad dog. I think there's one on the roof up here. Oh, there's more than one. Oh, shit. I didn't realize I was low on health. I did not realize I was low on health at all. When's my save game from? I don't remember when I last saved it. It's gotta be an autosave. Oh shit, all the way back here. You opened the gate, dog me. Good for you. Okay, let's try this again. Oh, poor doggy. They're bad dogs, but it still feels weird to make their head explode. It's a legendary enemy. Legendary enemy tripped on their shoelaces. Crippled. Got lots of steaks and baked stuff. You know what, just forget bats. Oh, that one actually hit. more enemies down below. And one somewhere over there. Haven't even gone down into the place, into the main instance of the place, Andrew Station. I'm still just on the outside. Balls! I could take these and put these on my pool table. Yeah. They're even differently numbered. 7 ball, 3 ball, 1 ball. Oh, I'm taking every single one of these. Any balls in the buckets? Nope. Any balls spill over? Nope. I don't think I killed every single enemy around here, but they seem to have left me alone for now, so I'm just gonna loot.
That's it.
Turret control? You mean the turret that's blown up? Deactivate? Don't think there's anything to deactivate. Check upstairs. Oh crap. Gotta make sure I loot the legendary raider too. Probably got good stuff. Ah, here we go. Ghoul Slayer's synth right arm. Reduces damage from ghouls by 15%. Oh hey, light dog armor. I can put that on dog meat. Also the bandana probably too, but I like the red one. Okay, hold on. Before I do that, let me just check the piece of apparel I just picked up, see if it's any better. So what's my current right arm? Lucky. +2 luck. I'd rather go with the +2 luck, even though the stats in terms of defense are much better. I like the +2 luck. Okay, Dogmeat, I've got some armor for you. Come here, boy.
Hey, over here. Wait there. Hey.
Yeah, there we go, adventure doggy. Gotta say, that armor's really hideous looking, but you know what? The protection is what matters. Also, it gives you a handle, so I can pick you up if I need to, dog meat.
Psst. Here. Over there.
You're so cute. God damn it. Why do I keep falling off that? What'd you find, dog meat? It's the cutest sound. What? What, boy? What? Oh, good boy. Found me some missiles and 45 rounds. Okay, well, I did want to finish this little adventure and go into the station and completely finish exploring this place before I ended the episode, but if I do that, I think it's going to end up being like an hour and a half. So let's just cut it off here, and I'll explore the station in the next episode. This has been a really fun episode. There's been so many cool things to do. Building artillery, showing you all the things I built at the settlement, and hearing Dog Meat's adorable barks.
Come on. Stay. Moving out.
So cute. I love you, Dog Meat. Got dog armor and just so many cool things. So many cool things to show and do. So I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm gonna explore the station.